Right, hello everybody. Well, this is a bad one. This is a bad one. This is a real bad one. 25-10-1. Is the only team that you lost to the Dimmy Refutation? Yeah, he lost 3-0 versus Amazons. That's the only match he's lost. 3-0 to Zons. He's got a claw palm. And Lady Bits. He's got the Lady Bits ball. Annoying balls, and he's got the sheer hands carrier. He's got claw, hasn't he? Yeah, he's got three claws. He's got a claw in the claw palm. He's got 60 TV a bloat. But he's full scummed a wizard. Asshole. Call the Inarian police. Yeah, exactly. Try. He's got a slack in the record, hasn't he? He doesn't have to win this. He's got a lot of slack in the record. He's not maximizing chalice equity, is he? As Dial would love to inform him. Your blind spin. Wish he hadn't blind spin, he didn't have to. Nobody forced him to blind spin. Tree shit. Instant full Jimmy Snap. Yeah, exactly, Chimney. Well, I mean, you get 50 more, so you'd only get 50 more, wouldn't you? Because I wouldn't have got, like, you know, it wouldn't have given me a whole extra player. Win ladder, yeah. Yeah, winning ladder's silly, isn't it? Chalice equity is the only thing that matters. Well, not that it matters at all, anyways, but you know. So really, who's to say if winning Chalice is more important than getting first and second? So yeah, if that's what he wants to do, that's what he wants to do, isn't it? Like, it, nothing matters, does it, in the end? It's all bullshit. Good. Good. Conceding 18 times. Nice pile on, mate. It could be the end times, yep. Funniest thing is, if he didn't have sure hands, there'd be a reasonable chance of just winning this half 1-0, wouldn't there? Just the record, really, for Fibrito. Like, sidestep on him would be better, obviously, only 5 SPPs. Block on him would be better for 9. And he could get sure feet, but nothing's really required. Okay, can't hide from him. Not really, Zaka, no, it's a bit shit, isn't it? No, Russell. Just means he gets to call upon, doesn't it? Wow, what a mentalist. Wow. Do you know that's a hobgoblin? You fucking loon. What on earth? What's his record, Chunter? Will he have time? That is the question, I guess. Just to get the games in. Churgen's record's really good. And Daedal's is really good as well, isn't it? Definitely not 4 wins away because he'd be on the thing. Yeah, that's why he had no fear of putting the hobbles out. Yeah, exactly. Good. That's why you don't stand the guys up there. Oh yeah, 12-0. He is on the sheet now. I guess the 12th win got him on the thing. So he's seven wins behind first. Maybe he's 4 wins away from getting top 4. Yeah, maybe he's 4 wins away from getting top 4. Shouldn't have stood up, should I? Should have left all 3 of them down. It's not so much that's the meta, it's just that they're like the best team at doing it at the end, aren't they? You know, when you're going to be down TV every game, you might as well pick a team that can win with a wizard. Yeah, like it's just natural for like Skaven, Elves, Kislev, all those kind of shit races to like do a run at the end, because you get, you know, the wizard is really good. Whereas a bash team, if you're down 10 guard, the wizard isn't going to do you a lot of good. The reverse Dakar. The ballless Dakar. Indeed, Lemon, yeah. Oh, imagine if he double won there. That would have been amazing. That's not a trap, he's got a guard in all the corners. Well, a double one wouldn't have been a trap, would it? Wouldn't a double one could have got him. Wish I'd just lied down. I don't care what you think, fucking around. Can't get it, Fluffy Burrito. This is fine. I only care about the dancer, so as long as I can screen the dancer, that's the only thing that matters, isn't it? So I just needed people around the dancer so I can screen him. It's literally the only thing that mattered. Like all these hits, okay, he's randomly got insanely lucky. Because of course he has. But you know. Everyone I've played has just got insanely lucky. It's really quite frustrating. Really quite frustrating how insanely lucky everybody has got who's played me. Just stupid, isn't it? I should never have stood those guys up, though. Like, I just shouldn't have. I just shouldn't have. That was real dumb, standing those three up. Just super dumb. Two of them have been cast. There was just no reason to ever stand anybody up. Ever. This whole half was always just a lie-down half. Incredibly dumb. But I mean, still obviously got insanely unlucky, but... Here's a wrestle lino. But 10 men max for the second half, isn't it already? So it's pretty shit to have taken 4 fucking cars. It's still an absolute dicey, but I guess I should never have stood those three up. That was so stupid. Lesson learned, if you're gonna lie down properly. Yeah, it's just idiotic standing there. So he could hit with him next turn, I guess. But he was never gonna, so he shouldn't have made any. I can't believe I stood them up. That's so fucking stupid. I wonder if it's worth blitzing him or not. Oh no, I guess it's worth getting the extra pushes, right? Yeah, just get the extra pushes. Ah, but then I guess if I go there, he could perfect defense me, so maybe I'll go here. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. No, it's got it. So the dancer runs. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Hits him, pushes him in there, gets him one forward. And then maybe he pushes him another one forward as well. That's probably better than dicking around trying to GFI to do them. I wonder if that's worth it. Needed three players in, and he would have had to dodge, so the catcher should have been there, but even then it's a 1 in 36. So what have I got to do? That. with a team reroll. Oh, okay. I can samba it. 3. Alright, here we go. Alright, let's samba it. So we've got dodge. 3-2. And then there's a 2 without dodge. And then 2 GFIs. And then we've got a 2 plus is 68.46 or 65.8, so the edge 5 is better. I knew I had loads of time. Guess I should have blitzed through the back line here. Taken 4 cars. Yeah. Yeah, it's good to know, isn't it? Good to know what's best. I mean, diced as well. Like, it's an absolute dicing to have taken 4 fucking cars on a lying down defense. But, you know. Oh no, playing for the loss, just hoping no one dies. Yeah, I'm still tempted to make the second account for the Zons every season. Second account for the win rate challenge. Just play Zons. And then obviously maybe win Chalice with them as well if you get a team like Dio's. Oh, baby. Oh, baby, Hellboy. I might be able to guess what you recorded. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Well, that is going to cheer me up, yeah. It's my national anthem, basically. I mean, we've actually done a national anthem. To be fair, you've already done an actual national anthem. But this is like Blood Bowl's national anthem. I can't even cover the screen to DAC it. I can't even properly DAC it. God, what an annoying fucking stupid shit game, honestly. I mean, it was my fault that I stood up, to be fair. Like, it's very annoying that I always keep making, like, minor mistakes, but then still getting absolutely fucked by the dice anyway. Like, it's been a shocking run lately. Though last game I rolled some good dice at the end, didn't I? To be fair. At least he's got 2 SPPs. Yeah, exactly, yeah. Same with, like, flings. You could have an insane record with flings, couldn't you? Just by playing game one of flings 100 times. You could get a really good fling record. Good. Concede before the fireball. Top strats. Now I regret not appoing the death. It's disappointing, isn't it? It's just, there's just stupidly bad luck on all the cards. And the death. I mean, the death is okay because I have plenty of money. But still, I would rather have kept him. That was the worst puzzle matchup, though, and I was feeling like shit anyway. So there you go, fantastic, that's the record, getting further absolutely fucked to oblivion. thanks for watching, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe and stay fantastic.